The SVTV Filmmaker Interview Series is brought to you by Roche Winery and Tasting Room at 122 West Bain Street in Sonoma.
I'm Rick Love for the 2014 Sonoma International Film Festival Filmmaker Interview Series here on SVTV 27, conducting our interviews downtown at Roche Winery on the Sonoma Wood Plaza, and I have with me lead actor Steve West of the short film playing in the festival, The Morning After. Welcome.
Thank you.
So your film, a woman wakes up naked next to a stranger and has no recollection of the previous night.
Yes.
Yeah, we've all been there, I think. It's a little scary, The Morning After, which is interesting. That's a title that is so loaded, and it's, I thought of The Poseidon Adventure, one of my favorite movies growing up, the song The Morning After, and it's a very loaded title.
I guess so. I mean, maybe David, the director, and Mia, that was their intention. But the film itself is just a very, it's a really nice romantic comedy based around that premise that you wake up, she wakes up next to me, who's a lounge singer, and she kind of, through the film, has flashbacks to the night before. And then there's a special connection that happens. There's a lot more going on in the film, and I like the way that it's wrapped up in sort of 15 minutes.
It's amazing. They got a lot in there, and it looks like there was a lot of kind of improvisational things that they cut down. Is that the way they approached it, or was everything on the page?
We took what was on the page, and David was very open to us doing our own thing within that. I don't know if we strayed from the script as much as we kind of added in a lot of our own flavor and stuff. I mean, when I first read it, I really kind of had an idea of this guy. I just kind of like this. And we're two contrasts. I'm this sort of British, cheeky, chappy kind of thing who's, lives his life moment to moment, and she's very structured. Mm-hmm. And then that's the kind of the story between us two, is that we have this special connection, which neither of us expect.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think one of the things about romantic comedy is there are kind of rules to romantic comedy, and there are expectations that set. And as an actor, is that something that is comfortable, or is it something where I have to kind of challenge and push back against this idea of what the lead in a romantic comedy is like?
I don't know. I didn't really feel anything. That was the nice thing about doing this project, was I didn't really feel any of those sometimes classic constraints. I mean, I've had other jobs where it felt you must fit into a mold.
You're the Hugh Grant guy or something like that.
Yeah, there was never, I mean, even they didn't even write it for a British person. They wrote for, they just wrote it, and, David's Canadian, but I think they had an American guy in mind, and I just came in and did my thing with it. And he was very, they were all very open to it and kind of just to let it happen. With their own specific idea on it, but there was none of this, like, this must be this and this must be that. We kind of like all came together. And I think that's the nice thing about doing shorts or independent stuff. Sometimes the bigger stuff has actually more constraints on you.
Well, one of the things that, it's a really great looking film, and I looked at some of the production stills. You actually shot this on a sound stage.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you had no ceiling and lights could come in. So talk a little bit about the production. It looked for that the type of production values you usually have in a short film, yours is exceptional looking.
Yeah, because we had the use of the sound stage at UCLA, which is where I think David graduated from. And so, basically, yeah, they built us, the bedroom was there. And then there's a moment in the film, I don't think I'm giving anything away, where that all kind of like dissolves into the night before, and the kind of the lights, the disco light, it's a disco ball, but and I'm singing kind of Frank Sinatra. So all of that kind of, they managed to do that because we had the soundstage. So the bedroom could break apart and become this thing. And we were just very lucky, I think, to have that, to be able to use that. And we shot it over a weekend, which was pretty intense, but
I bet. But there's something about being able to light it perfectly. Yeah. I mean, the DP gets to light it exactly the way they want to when you're using the soundstage, and you don't have the constraints of natural light windows and an 8-foot ceiling and things like that. So it really makes a big difference.
Yeah, and we had some great. We had a composer, and we were able to go to a studio and actually record the song separately. And so a lot of those finer things that you have on bigger budget situations, we managed to take advantage of on this.
A husband and wife team, an actor of producer and director. Your director is also a doctor,
yeah.
And your producer is a lawyer. And this is what just kind of their, let's, instead of just going to Catalina, we'll do this.
Well, and they have children. So I have, don't ask me how they have any time to do anything but other than that. But yeah, they're quite, Mia and David are quite exceptional people, really, mm-hmm. in terms of what they managed to fit in.
Yeah, it was impressive. And reading in the press materials that David is paraplegic as well. So the challenges of directing, when you think of guerrilla filmmaking, I mean, that's right. that's a very challenging thing. So it makes it that much more impressive that it's such a great looking film.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, that's the great thing about him. That doesn't even really register mm-hmm. Because it's never an issue, I think.
Clearly it's not an issue for him.
No,
he's a doctor and he's a filmmaker.
Yeah, I think that's the key, really. That never really occurred to us with filming. Maybe the odd time of, you know, accessibility is the only other time it mm-hmm. becomes a thing.
Yeah, so what's next for you?
For me, things have been great. I was on Mad Men last year, and then I've also been doing a big project with Sony, which is motion capture. I don't know if you know
yes.
anything about it, which is funny.
The ping pong balls.
But it's really an amazing, it's been an amazing experience. But I'm not allowed to say too much because it comes out late this year and they have to do their own press on it. But that's been an amazing experience. And I also work, I do a lot of voice work. So I've got, I'm always kind of doing some film narration and I do books and stuff like that. So
all right.
So things are busy, which is really nice.
That is great. And your film here is The Morning After, lead actor Steve West, appearing in the Sonoma International Film Festival. And this is our 2014 Filmmaker Interview Series here on SVTV 27.